Thursday, the second week of Lent, for the repose of the soul of Abbey Armour Joseph. I hope I pronounced that correctly, or near enough. Eternal, was it good escape? Yeah. Eternal rest from the Fernando Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were lifted up to draw all people to yourself. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You showed the cross to bear our suffering and sinfulness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ,
have mercy. You opened for your people the way from death into life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Your mighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, to give the blind seeing innocence and restore it. Direct the hearts of your servants to yourself, that caught up in the fire of your spirit, we may be found steadfast in faith and effective in works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the Pharisees, there was a rich man who used to dress in purple and fine linen and feast magnificently every day. And at his gate there lay a poor man called Lazarus, covered with sores, who longed to fill himself with the scraps that fell from the rich man's table. Dogs even came and licked his sores. Now the poor man died and was carried rich man also died and was buried. In his torment in Hades, he looked up and saw Abraham a long way off, Lazarus in his bosom. So he cried out, "Father Abraham, pity me, and send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am in agony in these flames." "My son," Abraham replied, "remember that during your life good things came your way, just as bad things came in the way of Lazarus. Now he is being comforted here while you are in agony. But that is not all. Between us and you, a great gulf has been fixed to stop anyone, if he wanted to, crossing from our side to yours, and to stop any crossing from your side to ours." The rich man replied, "Father, I beg you then to send Lazarus to my father's house, since I have five brothers, to give them warnings so they do not come to this place of tormenting." "They have Moses and the prophets," said Abraham. "Let them listen to them." "Our no father Abraham," said the rich man, "but if someone comes to them from the dead, they will repent." Then Abraham said to him, "If they will not listen either to Moses or the prophets, they will not be convinced, even if someone should rise from the dead." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Christ. Jeremiah criticizes Judah for its quite obvious and flagrant sin of idolatry. The people were openly frequenting the places where Canaanite gods were worshipped. Perhaps it is not quite so clear-cut for us, but maybe there are many places where Christians are visiting instead of coming to Holy Mass. Again, the misfortune that befalls the people of God may not be so obviously experienced for the Christian in the modern world, but it often manifests itself in a loss of faith, a loss of hope in its own life. There can be an apathy sometimes of why bother with it all, and without realizing it, we can easily become enslaved to the material world. The first psalm, which we heard tonight, describes the misfortune that befalls those who trust in themselves. Instead, be like a tree which is well rooted, fruitful, and able to sustain life, but only if it is well watered. So without the water of the Mass, the Gospel, and the sacraments, the Christian will wither and fade. In contrast, those who rely on God's grace are able to see if they are bearing fruit. For the fruits of the Holy Spirit are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, and faithfulness. These such Christians are trees who are flourishing. The Gospel says our fruitfulness must not be at the expense of our neighbour. The neighbour may come from a lower class to us, whether that be social, financial, cultural, or religious, but they do not have a lower dignity. Do not be deceived. We may enjoy many temporal blessings, but all these things will pass away. Only our goodness, or lack of it, goes with us. Both the rich man and the beggar are carried to the bosom of Abraham, which we call heaven, where we experience our judgment. The rich man is not condemned because he is rich, but because he failed and deliberately chose not to take notice of the man who was poor. The rich man is selfish and not worthy of the name Christian. If we have been blessed with riches, whether material or spiritual, they have not been given to us for our own benefit, but so we may have a privileged place in assisting those in need. This is something we may wish to bring to our Lenten examination of conscience. fruit of the earth and what the human has, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be you,
Lord. Pray, my brothers and sisters, for my sacrifice and yours, may be accepted to God the Almighty Father. That what Lent and discipline outwardly declares, it may inwardly bring about through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Holy, 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 which we offer you firstly for your Holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to God, unite and double her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all those who hold him to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, his faith and devotion are known to you. For then we offer you this sacrifice of praise, of the offering for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Peter, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysostomus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and count among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, to Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings of a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants have gone before us with a sign of faith, of rest and the sleep of peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, for whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sin. Have mercy on us. Blessed are those whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord.
Let us pray. May this sacrifice of God remain active in its effects and work ever more strongly within us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In a few moments after Mass, I'll return to the sanctuary in case anybody wishes to make a Lenten confession. So, working on the principle that the radiators will still be working in the morning. Holy Mass will be in here at 10 a.m, followed by Adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. And then, working on the principle that they're still working at the weekend, their Masses will be in their normal places. So that's the Vigil Mass here at St. Mary Magdalene, the 9 a.m. at St. Marcus, and the 11 a.m. here in St. Mary Magdalene. Fingers crossed.